welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's the holidays. I'm feeling so warm and fuzzy inside. I love the holidays. I love a full glam for holidays. And whether I'm going out to celebrate or to someone's house, or I'm just walking simply to my own living room, I definitely love a full face glam and I love to dress up. The holidays for me are all about family, sparkle, and shine. So today we're gonna do a fun green eye look with a little bit of shimmer, of course. And I'm gonna use some products that I already love, and then I'm gonna also incorporate products that I haven't used before. So let's get started. I'm gonna start with my eyes using the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer in Light Sand. And I'm gonna apply this all over my lids and blend it out. The reason I don't like to start with my face is because, especially if I have eyeshadows on, I don't want all that fallout to end up on my face. You wanna blend this out all the way to the corners because we might drag that eyeshadow out. And I wanna make sure if I end up doing that, this part doesn't look different from the rest of the eye. I'm gonna take my Givenchy powder, loose setting powder, and I'm just gonna go in with a fluffy brush and just set the concealer to make sure that we don't have any wet spots on the eyes and everything applies smoothly on top. Again, I want to go in all the way from the inner corner towards the brow bone and drag all of this out. I'm going to be using a bunch of eyeshadows today that I've depotted, so I'm not going to be able to show you the shadow palettes, but I will try to definitely find something similar and link it down below. I know that some of these shadows came out of Morphe and some of them came out from BH Cosmetics. And the first tones that I'm going to go into are a little more neutral and warm, so let's get into it. So in this case, I'm going to start off with a little bit of a tan color, and I'm just going to apply this right here in the crease of my eye and drag it all the way in. This is just a fluffy blending brush I'm using. Anything will really do. This is a Japanese line. It's called Hakuhodo, and I love the way they blend, these particular brushes, but they're definitely not vegan. I got these a while ago, so if you're looking for something vegan, then definitely don't go this route. I usually don't do any color on my eyes. I usually just don't even really do shadows on my eyes. So when I do bring in models for my YouTube videos, I love doing different looks on them. But when it comes to myself, I'm just such a boring one shade type of person on my eyes, because I like to contour the face for myself, but I really steer clear from doing any kind of eyeshadows. Now with a smaller brush, this one is from Morphe M507, I'm going into a more deeper orange tone almost, just to give a little more warmth to the eye before we go in with that green. Now I'm going into a deeper brown shade, and again, I'm just working it in, and every time I go in, I'm going a little bit below the previous color just so it blends on the edges, but you could still see the gradual building of the different tones. You always want to make sure that the edges are blended so that way you don't have any harsh lines where the colors begin and end. I'm going to take a similar brush and I'm going to go into a dark green tone, and I need a close-up mirror for this one, and I'm just going to start working this color in from the lash line and then kind of building it up towards the lid. Now this is a very dark forest green, but I'm starting at the lash line, so the concentration is mainly there, and then I'm blending this up to give it a smoked out effect, and we're still gonna have a lot of shadows going on top of this. I'm gonna move on to the other eye, same thing from the lash line. Now that I kind of have that roughly placed, I'm gonna grab a fluffier brush and I'm gonna go into that same color. And I'm gonna start packing this color in all the way on the lid towards the middle where you see that orangish shadow. And with the green, I'm not going all the way to the inner corner of the eye because I do want that part to kind of still be empty and look more of the warmer tone coming through rather than the green. So I'm just packing it more so here in the middle and more towards the outer corners. Now I'm more concentrated on blending the lines between the green and the orange. So I'm taking a little bit of green shadow and working this in very lightly, not a lot. And when you're trying to build an eye look like this, you have to definitely keep going back and forth with the different brushes to make sure that everything is blending out. And that takes a little bit of work, but as long as you blend it all out by the end and it looks nice, that's all that matters. Now with my ring finger, I'm going into a different shade of green that has a little bit of shimmer, and I'm just gonna place this right here where I have that green shadow. And I'm gonna kind of blend it in with my finger as I go. Now I'm going into a different green that looks more like that, and I'm just gonna place this on top in the middle right here. And I love the tone that this is turning. Going back and forth into that brown shade now and just blending out the edges. I am definitely loving the shades of these greens, that they look so good together. I was kind of contemplating on doing eyeliner, but I also feel like I don't like eyeliner on my own eyes. So I'm definitely just gonna keep it like this, so that way the center of attention is this beautiful green. And I love these lashes because they're so comfortable. They don't come all the way to the front, which I can't stand for my own eyes because I feel like they're always poking me and I feel like I'm like going blind. Okay, let's move on to the face, because I feel like no matter what you do to your eyes, unless you put your foundation on and you contour your face, it doesn't really come through. And I already have a little bit of moisturizer on. So what I'm gonna do is go straight into primer. And today I'm using the Hourglass Mineral Veil primer, which I love. I used to use this a long time ago and then I ran out and I just for some reason kept using other stuff. You do have to shake it before you apply it, because like I feel like inside it separates if you let it sit out for a little bit. It looks white when you put it on, but it really melts into your skin. It feels like velvet. It's so good. When you're applying it, you feel like you're kind of like giving yourself a facial. And this is the kind of primer that you could just put all over your face, especially if you're oily. It doesn't really dry you out. It just gives your foundation a really nice base to set on. So this is really, really good for most skin types. I'm gonna use the Charlotte Tilbury foundation today, which is the Airbrush Flawless Foundation. And I'm gonna just apply a little bit and work it into my skin with a beauty blender. I like this foundation because it's so creamy and it just feels literally flawless on your skin. I'm actually just gonna grab a small brush and put it all over my face before I go in with a beauty blender. This looks a little dark for me, but I do have a fake tan until here, so I definitely need to blend this down and make it look all even. Usually when I do fake tan, I don't do my neck. I just do it up to here and then I blend everything else down. So and this beauty blender is more dry than damp, because lately I just feel like the more water there is in a beauty blender, the more I feel like the foundation starts separating, especially for drier skin. So I just started kind of washing my beauty blenders the night before, and then the next day it's still wet, but it's not so wet that it feels like there's water dripping out of it. And I just feel like that blends way better. For concealer, I'm using the Charlotte Tilbury Beautiful Skin Radiant Concealer, and I'm just gonna go in a little bit in the inner corners. And I'm using two different shades, one to cancel out any kind of darkness and one to brighten the area. Especially with a color eye, you definitely want to make sure that the under eye area is bright and the color pops through. I prefer something a little more liquidy that has high coverage rather than something that's more chalky. And I feel like the Charlotte Tilbury one is definitely not liquid and it's very difficult to manipulate and move around. So I don't know if I'll ever buy that again, honestly. It was just something I was trying, but I'm not too impressed with the consistency. It's not my favorite. For my face contour, I'm gonna use the Face Trace Contour Stick from Westman Atelier. And it is a beautiful color. I think this is called Truffle. Yeah, this is Truffle. And I'm not gonna make lines with it on my face. I'm just gonna grab a contour brush and kind of just take some product, because if I do put it up straight on my face, I feel like it might dry and just make it look patchy. So I'm just gonna work this into the cheekbones and build slowly for some dimension. To set my under eyes lightly, I'm gonna use the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Pores and just apply it all over wherever I want my face to be powdered down. And I'm using a fluffy brush that I used earlier to set my eyes. I'm just gonna brush this all throughout this area. I also love how this minimizes the pores. Most powders are really good, but they don't do what this one does. This one just minimizes everything, all the pores, all the little marks on your face, and I just love it. I'm gonna use the Gucci bronzer that I recently purchased that I'm obsessed with. It's so beautiful, and it has these like little shimmers in there. So I'm just gonna go in and just press this against that contoured area to bronze my face. It really brings this really nice, pretty sheen to the face, which I love, especially for like a holiday look. I don't really want to be all matte. And of course, we can't forget blush. I'm obsessed with this palette lately. It's from e.l.f. Cosmetics. It's their powder blush palette. And it literally has these four beautiful shades in there. I like to mix those two or those. I just mix them all together sometimes. But it has two peachy tones and two more pink tones, which obviously are my favorite tones. So this was perfect. And I'm just gonna grab a fluffy brush and go into those two colors right here. That one is more chalky, but it's so pretty when you mix it with something. And they're very pigmented. That bottom one has a little bit of shimmer in it, which is so pretty when you mix it in with the matte. Yeah, just beautiful. For highlight, I'm scared to try this on camera because I've never tried it as a highlight. I'm gonna go into the Anastasia Iced Out Highlighter that I just purchased. I don't know if you guys can actually see how pretty that is. It looks really pretty. It has these like gold tones in there. So I'm just scared that it's gonna be too icy, especially that I'm a little bit tanned right now, but let's try it out. Okay, so moment of truth, let's see. Oh no, oh. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. You guys, that is so beautiful. I really thought that it was gonna, oh, I don't wanna go over that. Oh crap, whatever. I thought it was gonna be more icy, which it looks like it is, but I feel like when you apply it, that gold comes through, which is so beautiful. I love that. Wow. Wow. So pretty. Itchy eye. Oh my goodness. Does this ever happen to you guys when you have your eyelashes on and then your eye starts itching? Okay. Now that I did my eyebrows and I applied a little bit of mascara on my lower lashes, I'm ready to do my lips. With this look, you can also apply a little bit of green shadow on the bottom of your eyes to make it pop. However, on myself, I don't like shadows on the bottom of my eye, so I just always keep it very clean. I'm gonna go in with my lip liner from Huda Beauty, which is in Honey Beige. I've become obsessed with this lip liner ever since I purchased it, and it's literally become my go-to. I just applied the lip liner all over my lips, and now I'm gonna go in with my favorite gloss, and it's finally here, you guys. I'm so excited about this gloss from Formless Beauty, and it is in the color Radiance. The sparkle in there is so beautiful. There's three shades. It's Bliss, Radiance, which is this one, and Euphoria. I'm obsessed with all of them, but this one, just the sparkle is just amazing. It's so comfortable on the lips, not sticky at all, and it just gives the most beautiful glow. It's like a lip oil. It's so good. Okay, you guys, this is the final look. This is my version of a holiday glam. I'm usually not into colors, but when it comes to the holidays, I love the greens, the reds, the golds, all the silvers, and the shimmers. So I hope you guys enjoyed this look. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe down below, and hit that notification button for all future videos. Merry Christmas, happy holidays, and until next time.